I want you to do, I want you to find a way to get comfortable. This meditation will take like 40 minutes or a little longer. It will be the longest meditation because we need to get you energetically into it. And then follow-up meditations. Well, actually, lunch will probably have a long one, but your goal is to be so comfortable that physical discomfort doesn't keep you out of the experience, but not so comfortable that you are snoring and asleep the whole time. It's that, they say at the Monroe Institute, that fine line between unconscious and, you know, what is it, and technically minded, like you want to lose your technical mind, but you don't want to lose your consciousness. You want to be in that fine line in the middle where you are in hallucination. Yes, we have plenty of cushions. We have cushions, we have blankets, and you can relax over there and over there. Great. Are we ready? Okay. Everyone get very comfortable. During the meditation, if you find you're uncomfortable, it's all right to move, make yourself comfortable. It's better to physically move and maintain your state of haziness than to sit and remain uncomfortable. Okay, close your eyes. And I want you to breathe in through your nose. Breathe in a long, slow breath at your own pace. Don't try to match my words. Breathe in long and slow until you fill the air all the way down to the pit of your belly. Hold it in your belly for a moment before you exhale, and let your exhale take as long a time as the inhale did. And then again, breathe in long and slow, letting the air flow up and filter around your mind and flow all the way down to the pit of your belly where it can rest and then slowly rise up and gently flow out your mouth. And then a third breath, letting all the air flow into your mind, filter around your brain, and gently flow down your throat, circling around your heart, fill your lungs, and then gently float down to the pit of your belly, where it will rest, and then gently rise up and flow out your mouth. As you continue to breathe gently, slowly, I want you to release any technical, functional parts of your mind and let yourself just flow, be a passenger in this experience. Imagine that you are in a beautiful garden. The sun is out. Big fluffy clouds gently flowing by. Sky is bright blue. The temperature is perfect. If it were any warmer, it would be too warm. As it is absolutely ideal with a light, gentle breeze that tickles your skin
and allows the clouds to float like lazy puffs of wool in the sky, occasionally blocking the sun, and then the sun peeps back out, allowing the temperature to be constantly perfect and the light to be absolutely divine, never too bright. You look up at the sky, and without even thinking about it, you're seeing how some of the clouds actually do look like sheep or ships sailing. You see other items floating in the sky, animals, friends, what actually looks like a book. When is the last time you have looked up at the sky and enjoyed such a pleasant game of clouds? You stretch, breathe in, look around at the most beautiful garden just in its peak, with all the blossoms bright with color, and the air is heavy with perfume. If you sniff, you can follow the aroma to the honeysuckles that are growing in vines and bush over there to the side. And you can smell the roses. In fact, you can smell the aroma of the individual rose bushes. The husky, almost blueberry, powdery smell of the tea rose. That bright bite of the yellow rose. That beautiful love scent of the red rose. And you can follow the aroma with your eyes and see where the most gorgeous rose bushes, beautifully trimmed, well-nourished, are flourishing. And you see around you garden beds, flowers, flowering trees and fruit trees, beautifully landscaped all around you. And as you are walking through this beautiful garden, the perfectly maintained lawn, beautifully trimmed and edged, and you see ahead of you the most tempting meandering garden path. You must see where it goes. So you step onto the path. And you see, even as it goes through the garden, it's meandering a bit to the left, a bit to the right, serpentine. His beautiful landscaping delights all along the way. Tiny little periwinkles and wildflowers are sprinkling the lawn. Hollyhocks, zinnias, crocuses, tulips. You look around and you see such a beautiful expanse. Orchids. In the distance, you can see a rock garden with hen and chicks nestled into the little nooks and crannies. And your path is wandering and meandering. The aroma remains thick. Aromatic. But you notice the smell becomes a little more green, less floral, and this garden still as beautiful, but a little more wild, untamed. You are entering further and further out of the manicured and into what looks like a copse of trees, perhaps a forest, but it is beautiful, so welcoming. The canopy of the trees provides emerald light flowing through their leaves, and the air temperature drops just a few degrees, but oh, it feels delicious after you have been walking through the sunlight. And you can feel the ground beneath you becomes even more soft from all the years of buildup of the mulch where the leaves and pines have fallen. And become one with earth. And in the distance, you see a small group of deer grazing. A buck with his proud horns. And the mama deer. And several fawns that stay close to their parents and occasionally nuzzle their mother so they can get milk from her teeth. And you look up at the tree beside you, and there's a lazy raccoon lounging on a tree branch, just staring down at you. This is his quiet time. In a few more hours, when it's later in the day, he'll stretch and go about his adventures. And you can hear songbirds from their various nests in the trees calling out to each other. When you look around, you can see butterflies floating around, floating through shafts of sunlight that make it between the branches. Oh, how delightful. You continue to walk. The ground is a little more uneven, but perfectly safe. It just requires a small amount of attention each time you put your foot down. And as you walk through this beautiful copse of trees, you see the ground is becoming more covered with moss and giant boulders to your left and right. The trees are thinning out, and the ground becomes a little more uneven. Sometimes you use your hands on the boulders to help steady your way. But you very comfortably continue walking. One foot forward and then the other. And as the trees are thinning out, the beautiful, crisp blue day, the bright sun and the gently floating clouds is again there to greet you. The air temperature raises just several degrees, but it's enough as the sunlight touches your skin to warm you through and through. And you turn your face up to the sun and let the heat of the day just bask upon your cheeks and forehead. And you look ahead and see that the path is going down the side of a hill, a rocky hill. It's very comfortable to climb, but you need to look ahead of you, and your hands on either side to steady yourself, and you place your feet going downward. One foot goes ahead and steps down, and you make sure it is firmly planted and secure before you raise your leg and move the other foot. It's actually quite pleasant, this walk in the countryside. If you raise your eyes up and look ahead, you can see a vast view of all the countryside around, mountains in the distance, and all the shades of greens and browns and ribbons of blue river winding through. And you look up and you see birds of prey circling around, talking to each other as they're looking for a little nibble or a meal to bring home to their family. And you continue walking down this hill carefully but pleasantly. One hand goes forward, and then one foot, and then another hand, and another foot. And then again, your hands and feet guiding your way until you reach the bottom of this rocky hill. And you look up and go, wow, I climbed down that cliff. And then you look ahead of you and you see the path continues through some brush and short trees with wide canopies. And as you walk along this path, you see the path starts to widen. And again, become well maintained and the canopy opens. Ahead of you, you see a body of water. You can approach this water and look around to the left and to the right and smell that fresh water, clean, non-aroma that is so pure, it's an aroma all of its own. That water is so delightful looking. And you realize with your excursion, you've become a little hot. So you reach your hands into the water, cup them, and bring the water up to your lips and drink from that fresh, cool water. It is possibly the most refreshing beverage you have ever had. You can feel the water go into your mouth, cool, and it warms slightly as it goes down your throat, down into your belly, and your entire body feels refreshed. And again, you dip your hands into the water, raise them up and drink long and deep. Splash some water on your face. Pat some water on the back of your neck. Perhaps even drink a little more because it is so good. And then you stand up, stretch a bit, look around, and you notice just behind you, just off the side of the path, set so it's gazing over this beautiful body of water, there's a comfortable looking park bench. And sitting on that park bench is someone who cares very deeply about you and your well-being, your sense of love and joy. This being waves to you and beckons you to come sit. So you too, you walk to the bench, you sit down. And you greet this being who loves you so much. Two of you chat. And your dear friend says to you, I am so proud of you. I am so pleased that you are embarking upon this journey. And here, I have a gift for you. And this one who loves you so much gives you something. Says, this is to help you with your travels. And then your dear one and you rise up. And your dear one says, Now it's time for you to continue on your journey. We're going to part ways. I am going this way. And your dear one points to a lovely little cabin just a few steps away, with a light shining in the window, a gorgeous little garden, both flowers, herbs, and kitchen, there off to the side of it. You see a cat lounging on the front stoop, a dog, and several chickens in the yard. And your dear one says, when you need me, you can find me here. But for now, your journey is that way. And gestures ahead of you to stairs. Stairs that go up, 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 up to the clouds. Your dear one embraces you. And then the two of you go your separate directions. You walk to the base of these stairs and you look up. They seem to go up forever, so high above. Step after step. So you walk up the first step, and then with your next foot, you go up to the second step, and you realize this isn't so bad. You can do this. And then you walk up the third step, and you see that even though you have only taken three steps, you already feel like you have climbed very high. And you walk up the fourth step, and already you can feel yourself becoming lighter, less constrained. And then you walk up to the fifth step. You take a deep breath. Oh, the air feels more clear and more pure. It's very refreshing. And you walk up to the sixth step. And you can feel your shoulders easing and relaxing. And you walk up the seventh step. And you can feel your forehead and the top of your head relaxing, becoming very light, almost a little tingly. And you walk up the eighth step, and you can feel how relaxed your neck has become, your shoulders and your chest. Like the entire world has just slipped away. There is only you and these steps. You walk up the ninth step, and it is almost as though you are walking out of your skin because you are feeling so light, so relieved. and you walk up the 10th step, you feel relaxed, refreshed, and you hear a voice call to you. You look, and there on the side is again a park bench, very comfortable and welcoming after this long climb. And on the park bench is a member of your spirit family, your soul family, someone who loves you very deeply and dearly, not just in this life, but in all your lives and between your lives. And this being beckons you to sit on the bench, which you gratefully do. And as the two of you sit, you can look out on the vista ahead of you, and you realize with only 10 steps, you have gone up so very far, and you see all that you have walked through, the body of water, the little cottage, the bench, and the path with the cliff, and the trees and the garden, and the vista all around them seems so far away, as though you were already up in the clouds. And you turn to your soul friend, and your soul friend has a message for you. And your soul friend says, I am so proud of you and so pleased that you are embarking upon this journey. And I have a gift for you to help you with your passage. And your soul friend embraces you and gives you a gift. And now it is time for you to continue your journey. You thank your soul friend and then turn back to the steps, the stairway that goes up, high up, so deep into the clouds and yet above the clouds. And you walk up the next step, the 11th step, and you feel light and airy, and you walk up the 12th step. It is so easy with this movement upward, as your body becomes lighter still. And you walk up to the 13th step, and you feel as though your body is becoming so light, it is even spreading out. And you walk up the 14th step, and you realize you are relaxing out of your physical body and into your energetic body. You're allowed to flow around yourself and you walk up the 15th step and you feel yourself becoming lighter and more airy. You walk up the 16th step and you feel as though you are made of the same material as the clouds that you saw floating by. You are more light and air than substance. And you walk up the 17th step. And you can feel the warm glow as your energy is able to emanate without any physical constraints. Your energy is glowing from within you. Flowing outward. And you walk up the 19th step. You feel yourself becoming a light being. And you realize this is your true body. This is your true form. You are a being of light and energy, and you emanate with great beauty. And you walk up the 20th step, and again, you see to the side a park bench. And again, you go and sit on the bench. And there beside you, one who loves you so dearly, you will find either your higher self or your guardian angel or one of your spirit guides. And this one says, I am so proud of you for this journey that you have embarked upon. I am so pleased to be here with you. And this one who loves you so dearly has a message to share. And this one who loves you so dearly says, look out. Look how high you are. Your sight is even interrupted by all the clouds around us. But see how far in the distance you can gaze. All that is before you. And then your dear one hands you a gift and whispers something in your ear while you are gazing out upon this vista. And then your dear one says to you, I will see you soon. It's time for you to continue your journey. You embrace and thank your dear one. Return to the steps. And while you look down, you can see how far you are from the ground, as though it would be impossible to ever even return there. It is so far. But when you look up, you see it is only 10 steps to the top. And you walk up the 21st step. And you realize how light you are. It's as though you are barely even touching the step. And you move to the 22nd. You realize you are skimming the steps more than stepping. And you gently go to the 23rd. It's more like you're floating than skimming. And you go to the 24th step, and you're not even really touching it. And you gently float up to the 25th step, and hover gently. And then you rise up to the 26th step, and realize you can just move. You are not even touching the stairs. You are floating. And allow yourself to continue floating up past the 26th, 27th, 28th steps. And then, more like and
you rise up slowly past the top, the 29th and 38th step until you are there, the landing, the top. And you look around. And there, in front of you, are the doors to the library, to the Akashic Records. They are large and ancient. They are so big, you don't even know how anyone could open them without a team of horses pulling with chains hooked to the doors. And you step forward, approaching these doors. You walk up to them. You put your hand up against the door. You can feel the grain of the wood that was once polished, smooth as glass, but has been worn down through the eons of time. And you gently push against one of the doors, and silently, without any effort, it opens before you. You step into the library of the Akashic Records. Take a moment to adjust your eyes as you look around
the great, vast library of everything. As far as you can see, in every direction, there are shelves filled with books. Each book is unique and perfect within its own right. Each book has a unique story to share. And among all these books, one book in particular is reserved for you. Walk into the library, and you find yourself drawn to a particular shelf, a particular section, a particular shelf, a particular book that is calling to you. You can brush your fingers along the spines of the books, but there's one that is the book you are meant to read. I want you to leave the book on the shelf, but look at it, how it is nestled among all the other books, but look at how special your book is. You feel so connected to it. It is like you are meeting your long-lost family, like you are in touch with your favorite memory, a tremendous feeling of coming home fills you when you look at this book. I want you to step away from the book, and you notice beside you there is a giant table and a seat. You can even hear and feel as your librarian is saying, "Sit down, I will bring your book to you." And as you sit at the table, you realize this is the most comfortable seat you have ever enjoyed. And the table is just the right height, and it is just the perfect table for your perfect reading adventure. Put your hands on the table, and you realize this table was made out of the same tree that fashions the doors to your library. It is as ancient and noble and filled with as much history, yet it still has that beautiful glassy feeling as it's been protected inside the library. Except as you run your fingers on the table, you can feel little grooves here and there where Akashic readers through time have rested their hands and their books just as you are today. The librarian hands you your book, and together you place it on the table in front of you. I want you to take a moment and look at your book. How big is your book today? How heavy is it? What material is it made from? Is the cover leather or cloth, wood, metal, paper? Run your fingers along the edge of the pages. Are they cut clean or are they ragged? Are the pages made of sheepskin, papyrus, or is it a recently printed manual? Look at the cover of the book. What color is it? Is there a title or an image? And now it's time to open your book. You find as you lift it, it opens naturally to just the right chapter. Read your book. What story does your book wish to share with you today? In a moment, it will be time to return. While you are still there in your life, I want you to ask your guide within your life, what lesson did I learn here? Ask your guide, did I stay on my path? Where did I go off my path? And how did that affect things? Ask your guide, is there any energy or karma from this life that I need to do anything with in my current life so that I can be set for my best and highest well-being? It is time to leave this life, knowing now that you have imprinted with it, you can return to this life and this life lesson whenever you wish. It is time to return to the library, sitting in this comfortable seat, at this ancient, well-hewn table. You look at the page of the book. You see how familiar. This is a story that you know twice over, having lived and relived. And you know that all the other pages in this book are filled with stories that you already know once, and many of whom you will soon know again. I want you to close your book and again feel the edging of it, feel the pages, look at the cover. Is it the same as it was before? What meaning does this cover have for you? Now pick up the book and hand it to the librarian, who is hovering by your side. Thank the librarian. Relax into your seat. You can give one final gaze around you before you close your eyes. And return to the here and now in this space, in your physical body. When you are ready, you can open your eyes and again be in this room.